What's up, everybody? It's your boy, two-time Olympic high jumper, Jamie Nieto. Now, on my road to the London Olympic Games, I met some new and interesting people, and I had a chance to hang out with some old friends as well. I was able to sit down and talk to them about what was going on in their mind before and or after the games, to get some inspirational words from them, and also to figure out what else they're into. So sit back, relax, and check out my show called Holla At Your Boy. Let's go. This week on Holla At Your Boy, my girl, Hazel Clark. So Hazel, three Olympic teams, which one was your favorite and why?
It was by far Sydney, Australia 2000, because I made history with my family. I was there with my sister-in-law, my sister, my brother coached us. It was Team Clark, it was an exciting time. And I can remember it like yesterday, just walking into the stadium and knowing that we were on the front line because NBC positioned us there and like everyone at home could see us. And we did it as a family. I mean, I just can't really explain what that meant.
How did you actually get started in track?
Well, very reluctantly. I didn't want to run track because Joetta was a four-time Olympian, my older sister, and I was kind of over living up to my family legacy with my father and everything. So I said, I'll be a figure skater. I'll make my own way. And that was pretty good, but I got really tall and ended up doing a jump and coming down on my face. So that didn't work out. I tried tennis. I tried basketball. I was really fast, but I would miss every shot. So that didn't work out. And after trying really every sport under the sun, I got to track and field. And within a year, I was number one in the nation in high school. So I knew it was the right sport for me.
Tell me about your father and what he did for education.
Well, my father was, you know, kind of in many ways a pioneer. He calls himself a troublemaker, but a troublemaker for a good cause. He was very controversial. He locked the school doors at a very difficult school. It was a school that had a lot of crime, a school that was very, very dangerous, had low scores, and he felt like putting discipline in the school would be the first step in getting it to a level that would allow students to learn. So he did that. He didn't intend to be a big celebrity, but out of it came a job from the President of the United States, a cover of Time magazine, a movie written about him and based on his life, Lean On Me, and obviously a very strong speaking circuit career, and also he's an author.
Walk me through a typical workout or a typical week workout for an 800 meter runner.
We get up at 6 a.m. for our first workout. We'd be starting at 6 a.m. sometimes a 4 mile run, sometimes intervals, and then we take a little break, go to weights, like 20 minute break, go to weight training, take a little longer break, go to take a nap, lunch, come back again, hit it hard on the track, training room, and pass out.
Now that you retire, what else are you into besides track and field?
I have the Future Olympian Sports Clinics. I'm partnered with Dwight Phillips on that. Then I'm also a health and wellness ambassador. I just signed up with a new sponsor and also work for a big hospital system in Atlanta. So I'm pretty busy. Somebody said to me recently, you seem like one of the busiest people in track and field. And I feel like I got busier when I retired than I was. So I feel blessed. And I feel like when I'm around Olympians at events like the one I just did, I feel like it's a homecoming back to family. And that makes me feel good. I have a great relationship with my teammates. My name is Hazel Clark, three-time Olympian, 800 meters. Check out jamienieto.com. Holla at your boy.
Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you guys subscribe. And tune in next week for another Holla At Your Boy. Peace.
So glad you allowed me to do your hook for your show. I love Holla At Your Boy. Holler at your boy. I said holler at your boy, boy, boy. Holler at your boy. I said holler at your boy, boy, boy.